folks. We're going to be doing Lonely Boy by the Black Keys today. This is a Matt Corby cover of the tune though, so it's very different from the original. It's all acoustic and it's a really, really excellent song. It's a bit more geared towards the more intermediate or advanced player, so if you are a beginner, this you may find this a bit tricky, but it's worth having a little go with it. They will have the tabs on screen and they'll make a PDF available as well at the end of the lesson, so this may take a couple of parts. So stick with this because this may come up over like maybe a couple of weeks, okay? Also, if you like Matt Corby, check out my brother tutorials which are on my channel as well, okay? But enough chatting, let's get started. Okay folks, so we'll quickly talk about where our capo is. We're on the fourth fret here, okay? And our tuning is going to be drop D, alright? So for those of you who don't know what drop D is, the usual tuning on the guitar is E, A, D, G, B, E. What we're going to do though is we're going to tune this E string here, our sixth string, down to a D. Okay, now with the capo on, we should be getting this sound for our string. So this is our sixth string. Okay, then our next string. That's our A string. Next string. That's our D. Next string. These are all just standard tuning, these strings. Then B, and then finally E. Okay, so our tuning is drop D. Now let's go and get started with the intro. Okay, so our intro, I'm going to just play this through, we're going to try and play this through as one part, but I'll break it down into like a little smaller section. So I'll put the tab up on the screen right now for you so we can see what's happening there. We've got, basically, it's over three strings to start off with. It's on the 6th, the 5th, and the 4th string, okay? Now, finger-wise, I'll show you what to do in the left hand. On the right hand, what you're going to be doing is you're going to be using the thumb on the 6th string, the index on the 5th string, and the middle on the 4th string, okay? So what I'll do is I'll do this and I'll break this up into three parts. This is our first two bars. This is how our first two bars is going to sound. Okay, so I'll just play it through, just kind of slowish for you, and then I'll break down what I've did, and then we'll go through the next two parts. Okay, so we're going to play this. Okay, so what I'm doing there is I'm playing a pattern, and the only finger I have on the guitar with my left hand is at the 5th fret from the capo, remember? So we're on the 5th fret of what would be the 5th string, okay? So what we're doing with this, finger-wise, we're using thumb on 6, index on 5th, and middle on 4th. The pattern, number-wise, would be this. It would be 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 5. Okay, so I'll play that again for you slow. So it's 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 5, like that, okay? And you want to do that twice on this pattern, so I'll go through like this. Okay, so we hear that, that goes through twice, okay? Then what we do is we go on to our second part. Now our second part is pretty much going to be the same pattern, but what we're going to do is we're going to be shifting along. So we're still going to start here on the open string. That, okay, so our first bar for this part is going to be exactly the same as what we just played, but what we're going to do after that is we're going to change the bass note. The bass note is going to change with our first finger. We're going to play this. Okay, what we're doing at the start of this bar is we're playing the open and then hammering on with our first finger, okay, at the third fret on the sixth string. So we should get this sound. Okay, so you can see after I've hammered on, what we're doing is we're back to playing this third fret. So we're going. Okay, so see I'm holding this note down as we're playing along after I've hammered it on. Okay, and that's the second bar of this section. So we put those two bits together, we get this. Okay, so that's our first section for this part. And then what we're going to do to add on to this is we're going to play our third finger up a string, That's going to be the fifth fret on the sixth string. Then the pinky underneath that on the fifth string. And we're going to play the same pattern for a bar. So that's 6-4-5, 6-4-5, 6-5. Then we play a half bar of that, which is going to be 6-4-5-6. And then we play this cool little riff. The riff is taking off the pinky, like this, and putting our first finger down on the third fret here. Okay, that's on the fifth string. And we're going to play the fifth and the fourth string together with fingers one and two here. So we'll get that sound. Then we're going to move back our index finger to two and play those two strings. Then we're going to play a bass note, our fifth string bass note on the sixth string. And then we're going to play open on strings four and five. So we'll go like so. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll play through that section for you nice and slow, and then we'll go on to the last part of our intro. So it's going to go through like this. Okay. Now, the second part of our intro now, the next four bars, and this is the last part, is we're just going to repeat the same first two bars, which was this. Okay, so we've got that first part. Then at the end, we're going to change up to the fifth string part, which is five on the sixth string and fret number five on the fifth string. And we're just going to play this pattern. This is a really easy pattern. This is based over two bars. All we're doing is we're playing string numbers 6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6. Just repeat over and over again. So 6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6. Like that. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll play through the intro nice and slow all the way through, and then we'll move on to our verse. So here's our intro playthrough. And that's our intro all the way through. So I hope you guys found this okay so far. All we need to do for our next sections is basically use the same pattern, okay? So the verse is going to go around in a similar way, but let's move on to our verse writing. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll put our first part of our verse tab up on the screen here, okay? So this is our first eight bars, all right? So this is the first eight bars of our first verse here. Now, as you can see, it's very, very, very similar to the intro. In fact, it's almost identical, okay? Apart from, there is no hammer-on on the third fret. That's in the second bar and in bar number six as well. So, what we'll do is I'll show you through how the first four bars go. And then we'll do the four bars after that. So this is the first four bars of the verse. Once again, you can use the tab as a reference for this, but I'll play through the first four bars here, so if you can follow this through. Okay, so what we're doing there is we're basically playing the same thing as we did in the intro, but we are taking away, instead of doing this, we're just going straight into a, like so. We're just playing the note instead of hammering into it, okay? So that's pretty much the only thing that's different from that part, okay? Once again, we're adding in this cool little riff at the end. Okay? But that's really the trickiest part of the riff. So, let's do this second four bars, okay? So if you want to go back to the tab, you can, but if not, try and follow this through what I'm doing here. What we're doing is we're playing, once again, we're playing the same two bars again, Okay, so it's the same as the first part we just did for the verse. We're going to do it. Now on this part, we're doing our 4-5-6 part. Okay, so if I play through the first bar, it's going. That's nice and basic. Then it's just a third fret with the same pattern, so third fret on the sixth string. So it's just exactly the same. Then on this part, we're doing our pattern. That's the 2 5th fret notes here. That's fret number 5 here. We're doing it on the sixth string and fifth string. We're playing 6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-5-6. So you can see it just kind of repeats on itself. Just a repeating pattern back of 3, kind of looping round. Alright, so that is the first half of our first verse. Now let's look at the second half. Okay, so we're on the second half of our verse now. Put the tab up on the screen. So we can see that we kind of split it into 2 4-bar patterns again. The first 2 bars of each section kind of go through the same, which is just this. Okay, which is just the same every time. It's the endings, once again, that are a little bit different. Okay, so let's look at this first ending here that we've got. So the first 2 bars are the same. So that's just the open string here. Then the third fret down like that. What we do after that is we go to this fifth fret thing that we've been doing the whole time. We're going to be playing this. We're going to be playing on this fifth string, fifth fret thing. We're going to be playing 6-4-5-6-4-5-6, and then go back to 4 again. Okay, so that's going to be our third bar here. 6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4. Then what we're going to do is we're going to change it up. We're going to lift off the pinky, back to the third fret with our first finger here on string number 5, and we're going to play this pattern. We're going to play 5-4-6, okay? Then we're going to move our index finger back to the second fret and play the same pattern. 5-4-6, and then play 5-4, which is 2 open strings on the fifth and the fourth string, okay? So we're going to be playing this. This is our third and fourth bar of this section we're going to be playing. Like so. Okay. So that's how we play our first part there. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll play it through those first 4 bars all together and then we'll go on to the next part. So here's our first 4 bars of this section. Let's do the second 4 bars for this section. It's really simple. What I'll do is I'll play it through for you. So it goes like this. Here's the second 4 bars. Okay, so this is really easy. Our ending for this part is just going to be, once again, we're at the fifth fret here. I'm going to be playing 6-4-5-6-4-5-6-4-6. Okay, so on bar number 4 you'll see, if you go back or if you're using the PDF, you'll see that there is just a note that lasts the whole bar there, okay? A nice semi breathe that just lasts the whole bar, and that's just the 5th fret on the 6th string, okay? And that's all there is to the verse, okay? So, what I'll do now for you is I'll play through the verse all together, and then we'll go on to our pre-chorus. Okay, folks, so we're on to the chorus, okay? This is the chorus section, not the pre-chorus. This is the chorus, okay? So what we're having to do for this, this is the main part of the song that everyone will kind of recognise, okay? What we're going to be doing, as we put the tab up on the screen, is we're going to be playing basically just four bars, okay? Four really, really simple bars. And basic chords as well, all based around pretty much a D sus2 chord, changing the bass note. So what I'll do is I'll play this through for you really slow, and then I'll break down what I'm doing. Okay, so here's how our chorus is going to sound. Okay, so what we're doing there is we're playing a D sus2 chord to start off with. So that's third finger at the third fret on the second string, first finger, second fret on the third string. Thumb's going to play string number four, index is going to play string number three, middle finger's going to play string number two, third finger's going to play string number one. Okay? And we're going to play this. This is our pattern for our first bar. Four, three, two, one, two, three, two. Okay? So that's our pattern. Our second bar, all we're going to do is add the middle finger in, okay, on the third fret of the fourth string, and play the pattern like this. This is a constant pattern. This is eight notes altogether we're going to play. We're going to play 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3. Okay? Then, our third bar, we're going to move the middle finger up again, move our thumb up along with it in our right hand, and we're going to play 5, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2. And in the last bar, we're going to move the thumb up again, along with the middle finger, okay, so we're on string 6 now. We're going to play this part, we're going to play 6, 3, 4, 2. Okay, so it's 6, 3, 4, 2, just four notes. Then move along to the 5th fret with the middle finger, lift off the other fingers. And we're going to play 6, 3, 4, 2, like that. Okay, so we'd have... Okay, so that's all we have for the chorus. We just need to play it through twice. You can see we've got repeat markers on the tab that we've got had up on the screen there, and there'll also be repeat markers on the PDF as well, so you have to play that bit through twice. But what I'll do is I'll play this through up to speed now, just once through, and then we'll move on to our cool little riff that comes up after this. So here we go. Okay, so we're on to this, we're going to call this the riff section, okay? Not quite sure what to call this, okay? It's kind of like the post-chorus, but we'll call it the riff section because it's got this really cool riff in it. This is probably the trickiest part of the song so far, okay? So I'll break this down really slowly. We'll put the tab up on the screen as well so you can see what's happening. So this is our first four bars, okay? I'm just going to put up the first four bars here, you can see. What we need to do is we need to be playing a lot of different notes. There's a lot of hammer-ons and a pull-off as well. So I'll walk you through how this goes. Our first bar, all we need on the guitar is the third finger at the third fret on the second string. And we're going to be playing using our thumb and our middle finger only for this, okay? So we're going to be playing, string-wise, we're going to be playing 6, 2, 6, 2, 4, 6. Okay? So that's all we need to do for this. Okay, now that's our rhythm. So it's 6, 2, 6, 2, 4, 6. Okay? Now what we see if I'm doing is on the second note on the second string, I'm adding vibrato onto the note. Now vibrato is just basically wiggling the string, okay? What you'll do is, a lot of people just kind of do this randomly, like that, make it sound like a spring, or like keep it like that, when it goes out of tune. So what you need to do when you're playing vibrato is you need to realise what exactly you're doing. And your vibrato is coming out of pitch and back into pitch, only very slightly out of pitch, so you don't want to bend the string too much. But you just want to waver it out of pitch and back, okay? So the way I used to practice this as well, if you guys are new to this, is to watch for how your strings are normally. They're usually like pretty much parallel along the fretboard. What you want to do is you want to take the string out of its parallel place, okay? Bring it down, and then bring it back to its original position. Okay, that means it's going back into tune. Okay, so we should get this. Okay, so you can see I'm going. Right, still keeping it in tune, not going like this. It's just nice and gentle, just enough to waver the note and give it a little bit of ornament to it. Okay, so we're going to be playing. Now our next bar, what we're doing is we're going to be playing this note again, but we're going to be playing almost like a grace note into it, and that's just like a really quick note played into the next one. Okay, so we're going to be playing. First finger is going to play the open third string, and then we're going to play the middle finger is going to play the second string, and we're going to pull off this third fret note when we get to the second string off to the first here. So we're going to do a pull off. So we should get this sound. So see, I'm playing the index finger on the third string first, and then the middle finger comes just after it and pulls off onto the first. Okay. After that, you're going to go back to your open sixth string, and you're going to use your middle finger on your left hand to hammer on the open string on the third. Okay, you're going to hammer onto the second fret there. Use your index finger here to pluck that note. Okay, so the first two beats are basically like this. Okay. Okay, all we need to do after that is add in a bass note on the sixth string. Then hammer on again on the open to the second. Okay, that's on the third string. And then play the thumb on the fourth string open. Okay? Put the first two bars together, you'll get this. Okay? Hopefully you guys have followed that through. It'll take a bit of time, okay? So I'll play through once more. Just watch it kind of nice and slow. I'll play it at a nice slow rhythm here. Watch closely what I'm doing finger-wise on the right hand. Our first two bars, alright? Our third bar is going to move to the third fret as well. So what's going to happen is we're going to change the bass note. Instead of playing this open, we're going to use our third finger to play the third fret. Now we're going to play this. We're going to play six, and then we're going to play four. Okay, now we're going to use our thumb. We're going to go six, four, and then hammer on. That's it, the open to the second on the third string. Then you're going to go back up to this third fret note again. Okay, so we're going to go. And then we're going to hammer on this note again. Then we're going to go back two notes on the fourth and fifth string. Back up to the sixth string and do a really quick slide to the fifth fret. Okay? Now this bit's probably the trickiest bit of all. What we have to do is we have to be able to like make it flow, especially from the second fret part. So what's going to happen is we're going to have to do this. Okay, so you can see I'm making that slide go quite quickly. Okay, there's also a bit of vibrato if you can add this in. On that note there, that second fret note. Slide that note along. Okay, so that's our third bar. Our last bar after that, our third finger will finish here. We're going to keep it there. Then what we're going to do is we're going to play a pull off from 2 to 0 on string number 3. Play 6th fret note here. Okay, so we're going to go. Then we're going to hammer on the open to 3rd on the 4th string. Okay. Then play 6th string again, then open 4th string, then 6th string, and then we're going to play open to 3rd on the 5th string. Okay, now this bit is quite tricky as well, but I'll play through nice and slowly, so we'll go like this. Okay, So we'll have it again and play it through. Oh, sorry. Okay, once again. Okay, so what I'll do now is I'll play through these four bars for you, and then I'll quickly show you how the next four bars are pretty much the same, there's just one little difference in them. Okay, so here's the four bars that we've just did all together. Okay, so our second four bars in this little riff section, we'll put up on the screen now. Now what you'll see is it's exactly the same. Okay, so the first bar is just going to be the same. Same with the second bar. Now the fourth bar is the trickiest one, okay? So all we're going to have to do here is we're going to have to play two notes together. Okay, so we're going to be playing this fifth fret note here. Okay, we've just slid into it. And we're going to be adding in two fingers instead of just like pulling off on our third string, 2 to 0, like this. We're going to go, we're going to play two notes together like this. So that's the open string on the fourth string, played along with the pull off on the third string. So that gives us almost like a chord. So we'd have, same again, but then to finish off, we're just going to do 6, 4, 6, 4, fretwise there. Okay, you can play that with either thumb on both notes or thumb, index. It's really up to you. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll play through the second four bars, then play it all together, and that should hopefully give you quite a bit to work on for our first part here. So that's our whole riff part played all together. This will conclude our first part of our tutorial. So obviously keep an eye out for the next part. Like if it helped you, subscribe as well. Got plenty more lessons coming your way. And I'll see you in the next lesson.